Shin. Having fun.
Welcome, thank you for coming. My name is Manu from Leaf Audio, and I will switch over to my awesome presentation. It's about our sound box. It's basically a box, a resonating wood body with some metal springs, and here is kind of a kalimba. So sound is... Ah, there is it. Is the sound okay there? Yeah? Yeah, we have two contact microphones inside. One is here. Yeah, there. And the other is here on the side. So it picks up two different ways of movement inside the box. And we attached some metal springs. Some metal bars, a kalimba, and everything is based on an idea which I had almost 20 years or more than 20 years ago. No, this sound, no, yeah, there it is. Basically, Leaf Audio is about my studio and a workshop series which just happened by accident when I started in 2008-09. I started to do DIY workshops, and it just kind of worked. So, and over the years we worked with a lot of nice partners and people on music festivals. I don't know, like Club Transmediale, and we did stuff at Schneidersladen years ago, and yeah, a lot of nice things happened. Sometimes the door opened, I went through it, and from there it just went like it wanted by itself. The next workshops are on the screen. There are some in Berlin. If you want to know more about it, you can check leafaudio.com. So the whole soundbox thing is based on an idea I had in the 90s when I was starting heading into experimental music. And it was this wood block made of oak. I found it in the workshop of my father, and attached a contact microphone to it and just prepared it with some materials. And it was just meant really for the moment to explore some sounds, to try out different things. And yeah, then a moment later, 20 years ago, I was still busy with this fucking wood block. And it never got boring. I was never bored by it. And from time to time, I found out new sounds I never heard before from this thing. I used it in my live shows as Xabek, and I used it for my, yeah, for my music and sound design things. And all my trademark sounds have been done with this wood block. So, and by end of the 90s, I used it together with a compressor and then this Behringer Feedback Destroyer, because I played on a lot of industrial festivals, which ruined all the sound, by the way, but it kind of worked on the big stages. And yeah, with a mixing desk, compressor, reverb and this kind of stuff. And a couple of years later, the whole thing changed very much when I started using Ableton and computers on stage, and laptops were able to process audio in real time, and that with this kind of power. And I noticed that when my interface changed, so, or I would consider my Ableton patch, my MIDI controller, the cheapest one you can get on the market, and the soundbox or this wood block at that time became one instrument. So, and when this interface changed, when I was using Ableton, the whole sound aesthetics changed. I used all the same wood block over all these years, but the sounds I made and the way I played with it changed totally. And this was interesting to see and to explore. Yeah, and then last year I did a prototype of this version without active preamps. We showed it at the Super Booth and many people were interested, so we thought, hey, we have to finish it really quick now. We developed some active preamps which are very low noise and sound quality is very good. Yeah, so a lot of sound designers became interested in it. Some musicians like Boogie Wesseltoft, he was our first customer. He came to Superbooth last year and I was just turning around and seeing Boogie and hearing his music for many years now. I was very lucky, very happy about it. So he was our first customer. And meanwhile, people like Robert Rich, he has one, and a lot of sound designers, which are not so in public, not so visible. They work in their studios, but it's good to know and get their feedback about the instrument. Yeah. And we have this, maybe you see it now? Yeah. There's this input. So it also acts not only as an instrument, but as a kind of hub for further experimentation with contact mics. So you can insert contact microphones, so your radius expands a lot, and you can just explore materials and things with it. Yeah, that's it. One thing which happens with these kind of contact microphone things is that normally, if with hearing and with microphones, you have always these sound, the sound source, then the mechanical wave goes over the air to the nerve, to the ear, creates a nerve stimulus, and then you hear, or you your brain makes this weird thing, ah, oh, I know this sound, or I like this sound, or I don't. Or the whole thing goes over a loudspeaker, and then over the air again to your ear, and so on. And with contact microphones, you basically change the whole hearing perspective. It's like you're hearing materials from the inside, because this gap, the air gap in between, is totally missing. You directly change the movements, the vibrations, into electrical signals. And this is the same, everybody has experienced it, when you lean on a door and you bloop, 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 you touch the door or a table, you hear the material from the inside. And this is a very interesting phenomenon with this contact microphone thing. So this and the preamplifier is the basic core of the instrument. In the new version now, we have ultra low noise preamps. It's battery powered. It just takes 11 milliamps, so you can power it over a week or so with a 9-volt battery. And it's all about focusing on these very small sound events, like, where's the hair? I can't find my hair. Well, it's all about focusing on these very small events and giving them space without this noise carpet by bad preamplifiers you normally have on top of it. That's it. I'm done with this. I will make some music. So I use Ableton as my mixing desk with some reverbs and effects. And I will just start off and something will happen. Maybe I will use the low cut. Yeah, that was my way to play with it. Thank you. Other people do it different. Whatever. The soundbox, for those who are interested, it's available as a assembled version over Schneider's Laden in the US via Analog Haven in about 3-4 weeks. DIY in the US over Modular Addict, and DIY in Europe over Exploding Shed, our own shop. Thank you. If you have some questions, just ask me afterwards. Here are some flyers. If you want to grab one, just take it. Yeah, thank you for coming.